We know what that sound means. Welcome, everybody. It's let me move this real quick. It's Monday, and we are 7 minutes away from market close. I really wish I could have done a market open video today. That would have been really cool. Let me jack this up a little bit here. There we go. So I really wish I could have done a market open video today. But, you know, like I said, I work a regular ass day job, so it was what it was. But as you can see here, compared to last Friday at market close, we're doing better. Let me go back to here. So still down, but let's see, where was Friday the 23rd? 2, 5. Where are we at? So at market close, we were, it was a little past here, but we're right here. So last Friday's close was not good by any stretch. So we're doing good. Carnival kind of flatlined here. Tesla's down again. Not sure what's going on there. We'll get into details. But this is going to be a shorter video today. I'm just going to run till market close. This particular ETF has not been doing what I'd hoped it would do. We're on a steady incline over the last few months, but as you can see, we've got kind of a roller coaster going on here. So whatever, we're down a day overall, but again, overall for the day, we're up. A lot of that, at least for me, is in part to Microvision. This company's stock has been kicking ass. As you can see, I've just more than doubled my investment. So that's pretty cool. Clover is doing better. Not great, but it's doing better. But thankfully, Bitcoin is on the way back up, which is super awesome to see. Still 10 grand down from its high a couple weeks ago. But it's on its way back up. It's back into the 50s, which is good to see. Doge is still hovering right around 26, 27 cents. There hadn't been a whole lot of movement. And I was watching it pretty closely over the weekend as well, and it wasn't really doing much on its own. But like I said, I'm pretty happy overall because for the day, I'm up. I started the day, as you can see, down here. There was some Bitcoin movement over the weekend. But still, to gain back another 50 bucks today is a pretty good day for me and my small investments. Like I said, I am your regular Joe Blow run-of-the-mill guy. As you can see, I don't have, you know, hundreds of thousands or millions of dollars invested in anything here. I started my portfolio with 250 bucks. So that's that. Let's pull up the old Weeble chart here. Doge is still moving, but the volume is almost at a screeching halt. I'm not sure why, but I've noticed over the last few days that Doge has been moving a lot more after market hours. During market hours, it hasn't moved much. So I'm going to keep an eye on this evening and in the morning before the market opens. Today's high, as you can see, was 27.18. But that's kind of it. We didn't have a whole lot of movement over the day as a whole. Let's see. Let's do. Starting at about 6-7 o'clock this morning. You know, we were down here 26 cents ish. Well, it looks like we actually hit 28 cents today. Let me zoom out here a little bit. Okay, yeah, we did hit 28 cents today over the course of the day. I've been watching it all day long. 26.28, so we dipped a little lower at one point, and now we're 26.70, 71. So we'll see what happens after hours. Let's see, what else of note? We got about 2 minutes till the market closes. Blink Charging has been kind of on a down slope. It came back up a little bit today, but overall it's been riding the the downward part of the roller coaster over the last few weeks. Nokia is still hovering around 4.2, so not terrible, but not a lot of growth in the last few weeks. It's been pretty much stabilized right around that mark. What are some big ones? Organigram Holdings has been one that, man, a while back, I'd have to pull up the Robinhood long-term chart again. This thing was up to over $10 a share, but that was over a year ago, and to see them hovering right around here now is kind of crazy. but whatever, that's one of the American weed stocks. Most of the other weed stocks are Canadian companies. GE coming down, but still positive on the day. We are just about to closing. Yeah, about 15 seconds to market close. So that's probably where that's going to stop for the day. Bank of America doing good. They are up about 0.5% on the day. Apple coming back up a little bit. I know they started the day somewhere around $127 a share, so they've had some movement over the course of the day. American Airlines up 4.41% today. Delta up 1.77%. Amazon up 2.4%. Okay. Amazon making some gains. And NASDAQ overall closing at, yeah, we're closed. 14,138, not bad. They are up almost a full percent on the day. Square doing good at 255. Man, if you bought in on this and have been holding it for a while, you are doing good right now. They have recovered nicely. Tesla, though, right here towards the end of the day, decided to just take a dump. I'm not sure why. A lot of selling happening right here in after-hours trading. That's interesting. Wow. Okay, I wonder what's going on with that. I haven't had a whole lot of time today to do a whole lot of research on what's going on. I've just kind of been glancing over at my tickers. Man, I know what I said last week, Friday market close about Playboy, but man, I wish I'd have gotten in a couple weeks ago when they were still around $20 or $30 a share, because they've been doing nothing but inclining. It still makes me nervous. But I kind of wish I'd have gotten in and got in on some of them tendies. But alas, I didn't. So I'm just going to sit here and watch it rocket. I would not buy it here because I don't want to be left holding that freaking bag. Netflix doing well. 0.94% on the day. Litecoin has been going up. Well, it looks like it's starting to take a dive a little bit here. But overall, up 1.5%, just a little over on the day. Again, Litecoin, Bitcoin, all your cryptos are going to move 24/7. Coinbase has come back up to 304. That's interesting. Kind of wishing I'd have bought in on that 290-something dip. This says 299. Where? I thought it hit like 292 at some point last week. I feel like it got right about 290. That would have been a good place to buy in, but that's okay. Riot Blockchain is one I've seen a lot of people talking about. I need to look up this company. But it's on the downturn. They're still up 12.6% on the day. Let's take a look at the news. NASDAQ closed at record highs. Yeah, well. Yes and no. Okay. Ubiquity's up to 291. I really wish I'd have bought in on that when it was below 200, but that's okay. AMC up 13%. I still have some AMC in my Robinhood, I believe. I do. Up $3. Okay. AMC doing good. All right. DoorDash up just over 0.5% on the day. There's been a lot of recovery going on today. So we'll see overall how this washes out at the end of the week. But so far so good. This is looking way, way better than last week did. Especially market open Monday last week. It was a bloodbath. And by that I mean it was red, 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 red everywhere. But as you can see here, We've got quite a lot of recovery in green going on, very little in red. Johnson Controls. This one has been hovering right around that between the $58 to $63 range for quite some time, so it's a fairly stable stock. You're not going to lose a ton in this one. That was the biggest spike there. But it's been kind of hovering. It's down 0.14% on the day, so it's not it hasn't moved very much. Toyota down 0.34%, not bad. Dow Jones Industrial is 0.16. It didn't close too much lower. This looks pretty severe, but 0.16% is not a huge deal. I mean, the more money you got in it, the bigger of a deal that is. S&P 500, 0.7%, not quite a percent down on the day, not terrible. This is my ETF. Yeah, we're down 0.42%. So all in all, at least of my watch list, there's a lot more recovery I see going on starting the week out, so that's a good sign. Let's see how it goes. And I'm going to go ahead and keep this one short and sweet, folks. I will see y'all on Friday at market close, and here's hoping for the best and hoping I don't have to crack into about 27 of these. We'll see y'all Friday.